Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. This is part two of making a classic radar screen. Picking up from where we left off, click on the New Layer button to make a new layer. Open your elliptical marquee tool and go to the center. Press and hold Shift and Alt on a PC or Shift and Option on a Mac and drag out a circular selection a little past the inside of your outer ring. Click on the Layer Mask button to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. Drag the layer below the Solid Color Adjustment layer. Open your Gradient tool and double-click on the gradient bar to open the Gradient Editor. Click on the lower right stop and in the Location field, type in 25%. Click on the Color box and change the brightness to 35%. Keep the hue and saturation at 0. Click OK on both gradient windows. Click the Angle Gradient button, which is the middle one. Go to the center and press and hold Shift as you drag up past the inside of the ring. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Change the blend mode to overlay. Go to Edit, Transform, and rotate 180 degrees. Double-click on the thumbnail of the gradient copy to open its layer style window. Click Inner Glow. Click on the color box, pick Black, and click OK. Change the blend mode to Linear Burn, the opacity to 30%, and the size 50 pixels. Then click OK. Next, we'll add concentric rings to the inside of the radar screen. Make a new layer and Ctrl-click the layer mask on a PC or Command-click it on a Mac. This calls up a selection of the layer mask's shape. Go to Select and Transform Selection. Click on the chain link between the width and the height. This ensures they both will have the same percentage. Type in 75% in either the width or the height. Press Enter or Return to accept the transform. Go to Edit and Stroke. Make the width 1 pixel, the color is white, and the location center. Then click OK. To delete the selection, press Ctrl or Command D. We'll make two more inside rings using the same method. Make a new layer and make a selection of the layer mask's shape. Transform the selection, click the chain link, and this time type in 50%. Press Enter or Return, fill it with white, and delete the selection. Make the last inside ring 25%. To save space in the Layers panel, let's group the three inside rings into a folder. Shift-click on the bottom ring to highlight all three and press Ctrl or Command G. We'll name it Inside Rings. Reduce their opacity to 50%. Next, we'll make the other lines in the screen. Make a new layer, go to a layer mask, and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of it next to the empty layer. Click on the empty layer to make it active. Hide the guidelines by pressing Ctrl or Command H. Open your Single Row Marquee tool and click down on the center. Fill it with white and delete the selection. Make a copy of the horizontal line and go to Edit, Transform, and rotate 90 degrees clockwise. Merge the horizontal and vertical line layers by pressing Ctrl or Command E. When this window pops up, click Preserve. This preserves the layer mask. Make a copy of the layer and open your transform tool. Go to a corner, and when you see a curved double arrow, press and hold Shift as you rotate it 45 degrees. Then press Enter or Return. Merge the two line layers and preserve the layer mask. Reduce the opacity to 25%. This is the image I'll use to place into my radar screen. If you'd like to use it, the link is located in the video's description or project files. If you want to use another image, just make sure it's stark black and white. Go to Select and Color Range. If the areas you want to use are black, choose Shadows. If they're white, choose Highlights. Then click OK. Make a new layer and fill it with black. Since black is the background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Then delete the selection. To get the image onto your screen, drag it up onto the tab of your radar file. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the screen and release. Before we resize and position it, go to the layer below your black image and click off the chain link. Press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of the layer mask next to your black image. Click on the thumbnail of the black image to make it active and drag it to the center. If it's sticking a little, go to View and click Snap to deactivate it. Open your Transform tool, go to a corner, and when you see a straight double arrow, press and hold Shift and Alt on a PC or Shift and Option on a Mac as you drag it out or in to resize it. To reposition it, click inside the transform and move it. Continue to resize and position it until you're happy, then press Enter or Return. Reduce the opacity to 30%. The final step is to add blips onto the bright sweeps. Make a new layer and name it Blip. Open your elliptical marquee tool and go to an area of the bright sweep. Press and hold Shift as you drag out a small circle. Fill it with white and delete the selection. Double-click on the blip's thumbnail to open its layer style window. Click Outer Glow, the color box, and pick White. Change the blend mode to Normal and the opacity to 100%. Make the spread 15% and the size 20 pixels. Then click OK. Make a copy of the blip and move it to another area within the sweep. Continue to make copies and moving them to other areas on the top and bottom sweeps. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.